I was 9 years old back in 1986, and my life was pretty typical. I lived in a bungalow on the edge of a country town. I thought it was the kind of quiet, sleepy sort of place that went crazy when the Nissan Classic came to town.
And there's crowds all around. Welcome home, Sean Kelly.
I spent a lot of time playing sport. I spent most of the rest of my time here, in this school. It hasn't changed very much. My clearest memory of 1986 is going to Croke Park with my family. It was the All-Ireland Hurling Final, and it all seemed very strange. The hat sellers, the tightly packed crowds, and that awful smell of piss everywhere. Cork were villains in my house, because they always won. So I was cheering for Galway, and luckily, they were favourites. I remember it very clearly now, the hilarity around me as I bleated abuse at Cork. I hadn't quite realised that the flag seller had sold me a Cork flag by mistake. And of course, Cork won. I was 9 years old. My team had lost. It was a terrible experience. But at least I wasn't alone. You see, back then the entire country was well used to defeat. In short, we were losers. Our soccer team had self-destructed under Owen Hand, so the Mexican World Cup fiesta passed us by. Stephen Roach fell off his bike in Paris, Dennis Taylor lost his grip on the snooker title, and we lost our Five Nations crown to Scotland and France. Barry McGuigan won the world title, and then promptly lost it again. McGuigan is gone. And it wasn't just in sports that things were looking gloomy. The country as a whole was feeling a little down in the dumps. Unemployment was rampant. We were going nowhere, fast. But something strange was about to happen. Italia 90 was like a flower bursting into bloom. It felt like something magical had happened. It was like falling in love. And suddenly we weren't losers anymore. USA 94 might have been disappointing, but beating Italy in front of a baying giant stadium showed we could take on the best and win. A plucky young Irish swimmer took home 3 gold medals from the Olympics. A blistering new talent took the rugby world by storm. It wasn't just in sport that we were turning into overachievers. Everyone was dreaming big dreams. Our pop moguls were planning domination of the charts, our airline executives schemed to rule the skies, and up north, they looked as if they were making the biggest dream of all come true.
Nothing was impossible. Second best wasn't good enough anymore. We had discovered ambition.
But trouble was brewing.
We keep underestimating ourselves, you know, and so, you know, the good old Irish, you know, they'll have a good time, but, you know, we need to start winning matches.
Saipan was the moment where our newfound ambition turned on our old amateur values and went for the jugular. Like all civil wars, it was divisive, it was ugly, it was self-destructive.
But there were worse things than Saipan, much worse. As potential was unlocked, something darker sluiced through the system too.
Michelle Smith, once voted the second greatest Irish woman ever, was finally banned from swimming for 4 years. Those gold medals were worthless trinkets now. And then there was the most undignified, laughable moment yet. After a dire Olympic Games, our only gold medalist was stripped of glory.
Someone had fed psychoactive drugs to a horse called Water for Crystal. Ambition had flipped from tragedy into high farce.
And the cheats were everywhere. And for everyone that got caught, you wondered, had another 10 slipped through the net?
Everybody became obsessed by their own personal ambitions, wealth, property, status.
And who cared if a few corners got cut?
Ambition had gone too far, into greed, into cheating, into self-defeating conflict. It wasn't quite 1986, but it was still very depressing.
But then something happened. The grassroots of every part of the country came together to achieve something marvellous. And its glorious ambition won over the most jaded of cynics. Irish sport had rediscovered its soul.
The Special Olympics give telling testimony to the indestructibility of the human spirit.
And then I found myself back where this story began, watching Cork against Galway in Croke Park. A year before the nation's agony at Saipan, Sean O'Gohalpeen suffered his own agony when a car crash almost destroyed his playing career. Yet here he was, leading his team to victory. It had all been worth it. The effort and honesty and hours spent on cold and lonely fields. And it showed us that ambition is still something worth battling for. That achievement can be its own reward. It was a long way from the dark days of 1986. A long way from Saipan, from Atlanta, from Athens.
It was glorious.